What I'm about to show you is a short experiment that I am calling De Loin Pré, subtitled How to Surrender Your Will and Yet to Write. You will hear texts by three authors, all of whom wrote extensively on the subject of physical and spiritual transgression. These three authors are Teresa de Avila, born on March 28, 1515, in Avila, Spain. Died of an unknown illness in Alba de Tormes, 1582, on the cusp of the change from the Julian to the Gregorian calendar. She died at some point in the non-existent time between late evening of October 4th and early morning of October 15th. Marguerite Foret, born between 1248 and 1250 in what is now the Hainaut or Hainhauer province of Belgium, died by burning at the stake on June 1st, 1310 in Paris. Georges Bataille, born on September 10th, 1897 in Billon, Auvergne, died in Paris of tuberculosis and cerebral arteriosclerosis on July 9, 1962. The fourth of these three authors is myself, born on February 9, 1986 in London, England. Insofar as empirical evidence can verify this, still alive. The books from which I have pilfered are the following: Teresa of Avila's The Life of Saint Teresa of Avila by herself, El Libro de la Vida de Santa Teresa de Avila, escrita por ella misma, written between 1557 and 1565, Spanish. The translation I'm using is by J.M. Cohen. Also The Interior Castle, Las Moradas del Castillo Interior, written in 1577, Spanish. The translation I'm using is by the Benedictines of Stanbrook. Marguerite Foret's The Mirror of Simple Souls, Le Miroir de Simples Âmes, written in the 1290s, Langue d'œil. The translation I'm using is by Edmund College, Judith Grant, and J.C. Marlowe. Georges Bataille, Inner Experience, L'Expérience Intérieure, published in 1943, French. The translation I'm using is by Leslie Ann Bolt. Much of the material for this performance was generated by a process of bibliomancy, a proprioceptive act of divination using books or in some cases PDFs. In this process, the palm or the index finger searches over the written word, comes to rest at a certain point, reads. Reason's questions, and and so it has been made by human knowledge and human intelligence, and human reason and human intelligence know nothing of interior love, nor does interior love know anything of divine knowledge. My heart is drawn up so high and plunged down so deep that I cannot reach it. For everything which one can say or write of God, or what is more than saying that one can think of him, is far more lying than it is speaking the truth. Digamos que sea la unión como si dos velas de cera se juntasen tan en extremo que toda la luz fuese una. O que el pábilo y la luz y la cera es todo uno. Mas después bien se puede apartar la una vela de la otra y quedan en dos velas, o el pábilo de la cera. Acá es como si cayendo agua del cielo en un río o fuente, a donde queda hecho todo agua, que no podrán ya dividir ni apartar cuál es el agua del río, lo que cayó del cielo. O como si un arroyico pequeño entra en la mar, no habrá remedio de apartarse. These judgments should lead to silence, and yet I am writing. This is in no way paradoxical. Silence is itself a pinnacle, and better yet, the saint of all saints. The contempt implied in all silence means that one no longer takes care to verify, as one does by ascending an ordinary pinnacle. I know this now. I don't have the means to silence myself. It would be necessary to perch me at such a height to deliver me without the hope of a distraction to such an obvious state of ridicule. I am ashamed of it, and can say to what extent my shame is insignificant.
Suffering of the disintoxicated is the subject of this book. veíale en las manos un dardo de oro largo. Y al fin del hierro me parecía tener un poco de fuego. Este me parecía meter por el corazón algunas veces y que me llegaba a las entrañas. Al sacarle, me parecía las llevaba consigo. Y me dejaba toda abrazada en amor grande de Dios. Era tan grande el dolor que me hacía dar aquellos quejidos. Y tan excesiva la suavidad que me pone este grandísimo dolor. Que no hay desear que se quite, ni se contenta el alma con menos que Dios. Es un requiebro tan suave que pasa entre el alma y Dios. Que suplico yo a su bondad lo de ajustar a quien pensar que miento. Los días que duraba esto andaba como embobada. No quisiera ver ni hablar, sino abrazarme con mi pena. Que para mí era mayor gloria que cuantas hay en todo lo criado. Antes en comenzando esta pena de que ahora hablo, parece arrebatar el Señor el alma y la pone en éxtasis. Y así no hay lugar de tener pena ni de padecer, porque viene luego el gozar. Sea bendito por siempre que tantas mercedes hace a quien tan mal responde a tan grandes beneficios.